Hi, I'm Craig. I'm a developer. That's my job. I build things with a computer. I'm also a dad. That's my other job.
And I'm Patty. I'm 8 years old. Right now, my job is to learn. But my job got really hard.
Yeah, it did, right? With the school closing, everybody's jobs kind of got pretty hard.
Yeah, I really miss my friends.
Yeah, and so Patty and I were talking, and we came up with this idea for a project that we can build to solve this problem of missing your friends.
Yeah, it's a project, and you can actually build it yourself. Like, seriously, I'm not kidding. With a little help from your grown-up, your mind will be blown.
So here's the problem. We all miss our friends.
So what if we got everybody together on the phone all at once?
Wouldn't that be fun?
And that's really what programming's all about. You have a problem and you build a solution. So what do you say we build this solution together?
Let's do this.
What we're going to build is a phone application, but it's not the kind of app that you install on your phone.
Yeah, it's not like Angry Birds or Roblox.
Right. What we're going to build is actually on the telephone network, which means anybody with a telephone can just call your phone number and run your application. And we could do this by using Twilio. And honestly, you could do all sorts of amazing things with Twilio. Really, just about anything you can imagine regarding communications, you know, emails, text, anything. I love Twilio. In fact, I love Twilio so much, I applied for a job there and I got it. So this is kind of like bring your kid to work from home day, kind of. So the first thing we need to do is get you a phone number so you can write some code.
Don't worry, it's free and you can totally do this. But right now would be a good time to get your grown-up if they're not already there.
So now we're gonna head over to the Twilio website and sign up for a free trial account. Now when you sign up for a free trial account, you get lots of free credit. But if you click the link attached to the notes of this video, you'll get even more free credit. So here we are at Twilio, and it's always gonna look a little bit different because we're always making the site look better. So right now I'm gonna click this sign up and start building, and again, click that link in the notes for the extra credit. And I am gonna fill this out. So my name is Craig Dennis, and my email address is dennis.plusclassmates@twilio.com. I'm gonna sign up for a new free trial credit so we have the same experience. I'm gonna set the password to secret. And I am going to accept the terms and services because I read all that, and I'm gonna start my free trial. And that's gonna send me an email. And I am going to, on another screen, look and make sure that I got that. Awesome, I got that. So I'm gonna click it and we'll come in. And now I need to verify my phone number. And this is my actual phone number. And there's a reason why we need to do this, because we need to communicate and make sure that we don't want people making fake calls, right? So that's my phone number. And I think it's okay if people contact me. I'm gonna go ahead and check that box. Totally up to you. I'm gonna click verify, and that's gonna send me a text message. I got it, and my code was 528762. Awesome, and I'm gonna click submit. And again, this experience might look a little bit different when you're doing it because we're making things better all the time. So do I write code? I'm about to. What's my preferred language? I don't know yet. I think I like Node.js. And what's my goal today? I'm using Twilio in a project. I'm gonna connect my classmates. And what do I wanna do first? I'm gonna make or receive a phone call. So here we go. All right. So the first thing we need to do is we need to get a Twilio number. And you can do that by clicking this button right here. Get your first Twilio number. And I like this one here. And you'll see that I could do it for voice or SMS. It means I could send text or picture text. We're just gonna use it for calling, so all we care about is the voices here. And we got 202-937-0670. I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna choose this number. Cool, congratulations, we got a phone number, and we're gonna use that here in a bit. So I'm gonna click done. And then over here, you'll notice that there's this little menu where we got all these products and services. I'm going to go find my phone number. So I'm going to click this open. And I'm going to look here underneath the super network. It says phone number. So I'm going to go into my phone number. And here it will list all the phone numbers that you have. Right now, we only have one. And in trial, you can only have one phone number. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to open up that phone number. So I'm going to click it. I'm going to get into the settings.
So now you get to tell Twilio what to do.
That's right. We're going to program in a language called TwiML, which stands for Twilio Markup Language, which is a new language. So it's going to be a little strange at first. It's going to be like Igpe Atenle.
Huh?
Oh, that's Pig Latin. I'll teach that to you later.
And
the most important thing that I want you to remember about TwiML is that the case matters on the instructions, the uppercase or the lowercase, the letters that are big or small. Remember that. You ready? Let's go learn some TwiML.
TwiML works with tags. So let's learn our first instruction, say. We can actually make the call say any words we want. And it'll talk just like Alexa.
So a tag has a less than sign, the instruction, so in our case, say, and then the greater than sign. Then you write what you want it to say. So how about we say, ahoy, world? Did you know that ahoy was the first word spoken over the telephone?
No.
And then we close the tag. So that's a less than sign, and then a forward slash, your instruction, and a greater than sign. See, there's the open tag, here's the body, and then there's the closing tag. See the forward slash?
Don't worry, you'll get used to it.
Yeah, so let's do this. Let's make our phone call say something when we call it. So what we're gonna do is when a call comes in, it will run code that we write. And we're going to create what is known as a TwiML bin, which is basically just a place to save our code online. So I'll come in here, and I'm going to go down here under Voice and Fax. And where it says a call comes in, what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this to TwiML bin. So I'm choosing TwiML bin from that list there. And we're going to create a brand new one. We're going to do that by clicking this plus button here. And now we get to name it. Let's name it Classmates. So down here in the body, we are going to add our first tag. All TwiML begins with what's known as a response. So I'm going to add the first tag is response. Now, what I like to do, because I always forget, is I always put the closing tag right afterwards. So I'm going to make the closing tag. And I'm going to remember, that's a forward slash response. So again, I'm going to make this a little bit bigger. And I'm going to come in here, and this is the less than sign. Now, you might not have ever typed that before. That's right next to the M key, and you have to press Shift. You'll find when you start programming that there's all sorts of characters on the keyboard that you never used before. And here we have the forward slash, and the forward slash is right next to the greater than sign. So you can actually put tags inside of other tags, and that's what we're going to do. We're going to add our say tag that we talked about. So I'm going to come in here, and I'm going to go say, S-A-Y. Now I get to choose what it says. How about we say, Hattie is awesome. Okay. So I'm going to write, Hattie is awesome.
Dad, you forgot the closing tag.
Ooh, good catch. So I'll close the tag. And I think I should be ready to save it. If I scroll down here at the bottom, I'm having an error. What's wrong?
Remember, Dad, the case matters.
Oh, right. Good job, Hattie. Thanks for helping me. I better be careful, or you're going to take my job.
So we'll save this. And we'll save the number. We got to make sure that we save the number. Okay, so now we're going to call this number. Hattie, why don't you give that a call? Awesome.
Let's put it on speaker so you guys can hear.
It's great. Now, there's going to be a trial message at first. When it's done, just press 1 or something. Press a number. And you should hear your say.
Hattie is awesome.
Hattie is awesome. Good job.
Yes, it worked. Did yours work? Pause us if it didn't. Don't worry, you'll figure it out. Everyone makes mistakes.
Yeah, like I just did. Remember, there's a lot to remember. The case matters, the uppercase, lowercase, the spelling matters. You got to make sure that you got the tag opened and closed. Now, the code for this is in the teacher's notes here. So look down in the teacher's notes. You can get the actual code for it. Don't worry, you'll get this. Once you get this working, it's time to use our final two instructions. Now, there's a ton of instructions, but we just need two. We need dial and conference. So let's go add those to our Twiml bin. So here in our console, let's get back to that phone number screen. And I want to show you something. So before, when we had our number, here's my number. And here is the Twiml bin that's saying. So I can edit that Twiml bin by clicking the classmates link here. So it's going to open up my Twiml bin. Here it is on the screen. I'm going to make this a little bit smaller so it wraps. There we go. So we have it now saying that Hattie is awesome. Yours probably says something different. So the first thing that we want to do is to update this to say connecting to your classmates. Do you think you can do that? Go ahead and pause me and see if you can do it. When you get it, unpause the video and I'll show you how we did it. Are you ready? Pause me. Okay, this is how Hattie and I did it. So we came in here and we removed Hattie is awesome. She's still awesome. So we're going to type connecting to classmates, right? We put it in the body of the say here. So now when we call, it will say that. So now what we want to do is underneath this say, we're going to add a new tag. We're going to add a new tag called dial. Okay, so I'm going to start the dial tag. And I'm going to close the dial tag so I don't forget it, right, Hattie? Now, inside of this tag, we are going to add the conference tag because we're going to dial a conference. What I want you to do is I want you to open and close the conference tags so you don't forget. And here's conference spelled on the screen. Okay, I want you to add an opening conference tag and a closing conference tag. Go ahead and pause us. Do it for yourself. So why don't you nest those conference tags inside your dial tag?
Pause us. Then we'll show you how we did it. Ready? You got this. How'd you do? This is how we did it.
So what we did was we opened the conference tag with a capital C, right? Hattie, I messed up when I did that again. And then we're going to do conference here. So we open and close the conference. And now we need to name it. So let's just name this conference classmates, because that's who you're going to call right away, I'm sure. And let's look down here. It looks like we have a valid Twiml. Awesome. And I am going to save it. And with that saved, let's give it a call. All right. So go ahead and press 1, and you should be connected to a conference. So we're dialing. We heard connecting to classmates, and now we hear on hold music because we're connected to a conference and nobody's here. We should get somebody to be here. Should we get your sister?
I don't know about that.
I think we should test it, right? Let's get your sister. All right.
We'll be right back. We've got to get my little sister.
Hi, I'm Abby, and I miss you so much. And I'm in your class. Remember to say your name when you connect.
And try not to all talk at once.
I know. It's exciting to catch up with everyone. But you can't be like, blah, blah, blah. Oh, come on. Oh, yeah, Dakota, would you stick that rat up?
Also, don't forget that you can share this with your family, the ones that aren't trapped in the house with you right now. You can share with them. You share with your aunts, your uncles, your grandparents, whoever. Show them. They'll be so proud of what you build. I hope you are proud of what you just built. I know I'm proud of what you built, Hats.
And we can't wait to see what you built.
Thanks for hanging out.
Hi, you should really use Twilio.
I'm Dad, I love to program.
Twilio, Twilio, Twilio. Twimbleton. Oh, I miss my friends. I'm Hattie. We can't wait to see what you build.
That's great.
That was perfect.
Okay.
Marty, that was great. You
awesome.
Did sound really
awesome. What do you want? I'm going to get you something because you got to get paid for your work. What do you want? What do you want? An LOL doll? All right. Sold.